Welcome back. Today we're going to be looking at the third stage of the Metta Bhavana practice, which is the neutral person stage, where we try and cultivate an awareness and kindness and loving kindness towards a neutral person. And sometimes this stage can be a little bit magical. Sometimes it really allows you to connect with somebody and really see them as another human being, really kind of connect with your shared humanity. Sometimes it's a bit like neutral figures can be a bit two-dimensional, a bit like two-dimensional cardboard cutouts, and then when we put them into Metta Bhavana, they turn into three-dimensional living human beings, which can be a bit magical. But sometimes, other times, it's a bit more difficult than that, and sometimes this is the stage of the practice maybe where we can lose the thread, or it just runs a bit emotionally dry, or where we start getting more distracted. We notice that our mind just gets more distracted. So I want to look at what the reasons for that will be, if you've noticed that happening to you as well, maybe. So basically, in the first stage and the second stage, with ourselves and our good friend, in a way there's more naturally interest there. Yeah, we're more naturally going to be interested in ourselves and our friend and their happiness, as it were. Whereas with a neutral person, there's a less obvious or less immediate interest in them, maybe. Yeah, and even with the fourth stage, the difficult person, at least there's likely to be more feeling there, an emotion there, even if it's a bit difficult or uncomfortable. There's something there. There's some kind of feeling or energy or emotion. There's kind of juice in the meditation to work with. So in a way, even if it's challenging in one way, at least there's something there to engage with. Yeah. Whereas the challenge of the third stage, the neutral person stage, is there's not immediately and naturally that kind of feeling and interest to work with. So in a way, we've got to work a little bit harder. In a way, you could almost say that this is where the practice really gets going. This is where the Metta Bhavana practice really gets going, because it's at this stage that you're going beyond your usual sphere of concern, yourself and your friend. You're going beyond that and you're engaging with other human beings. So in a way, this is where the practice really kind of kicks in a certain kind of sense. So the key to this stage of the practice is interest. That's the key. It's about learning to cultivate an interest in other human beings, even human beings that we don't know very well or that we don't have a particular connection with. It's all about trying to be aware of our common humanity in that kind of way. Yeah. And I want to tell you a little story I heard once, which I really like, about someone doing this practice. And they, at the time, worked in a cafe, and there was a customer who used to come in every day and apparently order the same thing every single day of the week. And so all the staff knew him, and they called him Mr. Customer. He was known as Mr. Customer to the staff. Yeah. And then one day, the person in the story started putting Mr. Customer in their meditation practice, in their stage three of the Metta Bhavana. And what happened was, apparently, within a few days, he just naturally and spontaneously went out and started talking to Mr. Customer and struck a conversation with him and made a connection with him and maybe even learnt what his real name was. Yeah. So that's what happens. If you do the practice, it will have an effect. We start thinking of someone and maybe it will lead to some kind of connection with them, maybe even to, you know, a real kind of connection in your life, as it were. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to reach out our sphere of concern in that kind of way. Yeah. So in terms of working in the practice, it's all about cultivating interest. And maybe we are going to have to work a bit harder in this stage. Maybe we are going to have to engage our imagination a bit more strongly. And we've just got to, just be aware of this person. And even if we don't know very much about them in their life, just kind of consider, what do we know? Is there anything we know? Is there any kind of clues we've got which can give us a start? Yeah. So, for example, last time I was in my corner shop, the man behind the counter told me that his son was just going off to university. So, you know, I don't know very much about him, but that's a little clue to that man and his life and what's going on for him. And I can just put that in my meditation and then just imagine what his life might be like. Of course, I don't know. He's a bit of a mystery. That's fine. I just have to kind of imagine it in a spirit of as if their life might be like this. So you hold it lightly, and we don't want it to get it too complicated. It's not trying to dream up some really complicated scenario, but just enough of what's likely to be going on in that person's life to help us connect with them as another human being and hold them in that awareness with a sense of kindness, a sense of well-wishing, and so on. Yeah. So that's what we're going to be trying in the lead meditation practice today. It'll concentrate particularly on the third stage, although it'll also include the other stages as well. And also on the website today, there'll be all the other usual resources, the daily practice suggestion, the 10-minute talk from Vasantra, and a bit later on today, we're going to be posting up some responses from Vasantra to questions that you've been asking in the last couple of days. So do look out for that, and then I'll be back tomorrow looking at the fourth stage of the practice in more detail. See you then.